something wrong. See, something definitely wrong with my Zoom. It is giving me trouble. All right. So, to keep you guys safe and to keep myself safe, I've got myself vaccinated. And that is the only reason why our lesson is a little delayed today. We're beginning our lesson at 11:20. We will end it at 11:50, inshallah. Okay? Since the lesson is beginning at 11:20 and we need half an hour for our lesson, we will end it at 11:50, inshallah. Okay, G. Today we're going to read an autobiography. Anyone has an idea what an autobiography is? Can anybody tell me what an autobiography is?
Ma'am, is lecture from 11:15 to 11:30?
11:20 pe aap log aaye hain, so I will start from 11:20 to 11:50, theek hai?
Okay.
Okay. Yes, please. What is an autobiography? Have you heard this word?
Autobiography. I think it tells about someone's life.
It tells about life story. Life. Okay. Yes. And what else? Someone else, please.
Arima? It also tells about the writer.
Writer. Okay. Yeah. Sort of.
How does it tell about the writer? Ma'am, it's about a person's life, which story is written by another person.
Okay. It can be written by the person himself or it can be written by someone else. Okay? For example, have you ever read an autobiography?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Achha. The difference between autobiography and biography is that an autobiography is written by they are basically the accounts or the experiences of someone's life written by that own person, that person himself. Okay, and a biography about somebody by someone else. Okay, that's basically the difference. I remember when I was in grade 5, that was the first time my teacher introduced autobiographies to us. And back then, she basically made us read a story first, and then we wrote an autobiography ourselves. I still remember the story was about an old styled lamp. You remember that in earlier times, there were lamps which worked with, gas. They had gas mantle inside, and it was basically a street light, but it worked on gas instead of electricity. And that that autobiography was of that lamp, how it is, uprooted from its position, taken on a huge truck, and then taken to a factory where it is smelted and converted into a new a lamp, which could work with electricity. And how throughout the process, in the beginning, when he is being taken away, his feelings of sadness, of despair, his fears, they are all shown. And then when he is being, when he is being turned, when he's being heated and melted and turned into a new lamp, all the feelings that he experiences, they are shared. And then once he turns into a new thing, his happiness, his joy is explained. So the emotions were also side by side. Although a simple lamp, a street lamp, is an inanimate object, but the autobiography was so interesting. Imagine I was, 9 or 10 years old when I was in grade 5, and 30 years from then, I still remember the story. It was so interestingly, it was simple, but interesting to remember. So here we have an autobiography by the title, The Race. What do you think The Race is going to be about? Do you think it's going to be a school race in which children have an athletics? It's going to be children or adults?
Ma'am, in this text, it's a race of billy cart.
It's basically a race of billy carts. Do you have any idea what billy carts are?
No.
Go card.
Have you ever seen a card that looks like this?
Yes, ma'am. In a cartoon.
Yes. In cartoons, maybe. But in America, in Australia, children, as young as grade 3 and above, probably your age as well, they are in the habit of making their own, cars. Obviously, they're not motored. They do not have a motor inside, but they have the basic system of a steering wheel and brakes. The brakes could be within just like those children cars, if you've seen one. The wheels are supposed to work, and you can use your own feet against the your friction of your feet against the road to stop the car, or you might have tiny pedals inside to work as brakes for the car. So basically, these are made either out of old pieces of wood or sturdy cartons, and usually children basically, instead of feeling bored, they utilize their time and keep themselves busy by making a dirt car or a billy cart. And every child's design, it can be a yearly event where they're supposed to display their car and then race against other people, other children their age. So we're going to read the story of a young boy who makes his own cart and how he compares his cart with others and what his...
Ma'am, isn't she good?
He's a boy. He's got long hair. See, fashion badi cheez hoti hai, theek hai na? In every country, children have their own fashion. So he's basically a boy.
Okay. Ma'am, it seems like it's the 1980s.
Sorry?
It seems like it's the 1980s. He even has a mullet.
Yes. Not exactly a mullet. It's like he has these floppy hair. Okay? He has these floppy hair. Let's give it a read. I am going to read the introduction, and you guys are going to take turns and read the story paragraph wise. We're going to read half the story today. We'll try to read more than half of it today and the rest tomorrow. And then tomorrow we're going to do the question answers as well. Take care. I'm going to read the introduction. The following text, The Race, comes from the autobiography of the writer and journalist Clive James. Now, Clive James is a very famous journalist and writer as well. He is famous for many of the news reports that he has written for.
Poems.
Yeah, he has written poems as well. Let me quickly show you his face. I'm so sorry. I did not... He's basically an Australian. If you can see, wait, where am I? I can't see myself. How can I make you see something? Yes, if you can see, here is Mr. Clive.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, he is old.
Yes, obviously now he is old. He was born in 1939. So he's round about roughly 80 years of age. So James Clive is basically an Australian journalist, and he was born in Australia in 1939. He later moved to the United Kingdom in 1962, and in 2019, before Corona, he passed away, unfortunately. He was basically a journalist, a broadcaster, and a writer. Sorry? Did you say something, Arifa? Okay. Now,
I was also saying that he was a writer.
Yes, he was a writer, a broadcaster, and a journalist. And he spent, towards the later half of his life, he became a television critic as well. When he wrote He wrote for a famous newspaper by the name of The Observer in United Kingdom in 1962. That's where he started working in the United Kingdom. Okay? Now, here he is giving his autobiography, and this chunk is out of his book, his autobiographical book. And here he is going to mention how he makes his own, builds his own billy cart, and how he races it with other children in Australia. He has spent most of his adult life in Britain, but he grew up in Australia, where he was born in 1939. Here he writes about racing his homemade billy cart. That is, it was built at home by himself. Now, what is a billy cart? This purple chunk in your book, this is a piece of vocabulary. A billy cart is a homemade go-kart. Go-karts can be very sophisticated machines these days. You must have seen one at one of...
I think I have seen the go-kart in the Shiva cartoon.
Exactly. You might have seen them in cartoons. If you have an idea, those of you who live in...
Ma'am, there is a go-kart track in Phase 4.
Exactly. That's what I was about to tell you. Those of you who live in Beria Phase 1 to 6, right next to that Bull Steakhouse. Exactly. You have a go-kart.
Yes. Meaning?
Go-kart racing.
Meaning golf club.
Go-karts are basically very close to the ground, and they are low powered.
I think the color is blue, ma'am.
Exactly. Very simple cars to practice your skills on. Now, go-karts can be very sophisticated machines these days, today. In the current time, they can be very sophisticated. But Clive James' billy cart at the end of the 1940s was very different. The seat was made from an old wooden box nailed into a frame made from wood panels, usually used for fencing. That is, very simple equipment was used. What happened? Okay. Oh, this is giving me heart attack. The seat was made
from... And go-karts are also used in the competitions.
Yes, that's exactly what the race is going to be about. The seat was made from an old wooden box nailed in onto a frame made from wood panels usually used for fencing. That is, to make a fence outside the home. He took the rubber wheels for his billy cart from an old pram, from an old baby's pram, a pushchair. But some of the other carts were more technically advanced and had special steel jacketed ball race wheels. That is, you know, proper wheels. These wheels were made of strong metal and had ball bearings inside, which would make them much faster, stronger, and noisier. Raise your hands, those of you who have ever used a spinner, a fidget spinner.
What's that?
A fidget spinner. Ibrahim, do you have a fidget spinner, bete? My son is playing with his cousins. I can't call him. How many of you have ever played with a fidget spinner? Give me a thumbs up.
Who hasn't?
Ariba, this thing.
Yes, ma'am. I have played. I have it.
Anna?
Yes, ma'am. I have it.
Show me a thumbs up. Yes. Shakar, you haven't played with one? Hamail.
I haven't played.
These are ever so...
Oh, fidget spinners.
I love this game, ma'am.
Hannah, these are lovely. This is a simple, lovely gadget that helps, relieve stress and anxiety. So children...
Ma'am, the purpose was
to relieve stress, but it turned out a huge sensation amongst children
like this, man, right?
Around 3 to 4 years ago. Exactly. It spins. If you've noticed, it spins at a very...
Our finger.
Exactly. You touch it a little and it spins at a very fast pace. So in the last few lines, if you read from here till here, But some, I'll read it again. Keep the fidget spinner in your mind. But some ball, but some of the other carts were more technically advanced and had special steel jacketed ball race wheels. These wheels were made of strong metal and had ball bearings inside, which would make them much faster, stronger, and more noisier. Now, if you spin a fidget spinners are faster, stronger, and they do create a little bit of noise as well. The reason is, if you have ever opened up, if you've ever broken, I will say, a fidget spinner, because who would be considered a normal child who wouldn't break his toys, okay? If you have ever broken into your fidget spinner, you would see that there are tiny balls, inside.
Yes, ma'am.
Balls are basically called ball bearings. These ball bearings, they do not have much friction. So when you don't have much friction, things are more faster and more smoother and obviously stronger as well, but they create noise. So that was how, the smarter and more advanced wheels that the other boys used on their billy carts. So keep these things in mind. Our Clive doesn't have a very advanced billy cart. His is very, simple, while others have very advanced ones. Yes, please. I'll begin with Abdullah Amir. I'd like you to start reading paragraph one.
Okay, ma'am.
I could not build billy carts very well. Other children, most of them admittedly older than I, but some of infantingly not constructed billy carts of advanced design with wooden frames and steel jacket ball race wheels that screamed on the concrete footpaths like a diving.
Aliba, kindly remain silent. Silently read the best along with Abdullah Amir. Okay, Ariba? Yes, Abdullah.
The best.
Please repeat the sentence again.
I could not build billy carts very well. Other children, most of them admittedly older than I, but some of them intingly not constructed admittedly, billy carts of advance.
Admittedly older than I.
But some of them
I'll repeat it again. Infuriating means angrily, making the others feel furious. Say hai ye word. Fury say. Theek hai? The word
infuriatingly
meaning anger.
And not constructed billy carts of advanced design with wooden frames and steel jacket ball race wheels that streamed on the concrete footpath like a diving scooper. The best I could manage was a swan rubber wheel shaped of an old tram after school, and that weekends boys come from all over the district to the race on the Sunbeam Avenue footpaths. There would be 20 or 30 carts, two-thirds of with ball race wheels. The noise was indescribable. There would be about half an hour racing before the police came. Residents often took the law into their own hands, posing the grim-faced riders as they went riding by.
Okay. I could not build billy carts very well. Other children, most of them admittedly older than I, but some of them infuriatingly not constructed billy carts of advanced design with wooden frames and steel-jacketed ball race wheels that screamed on the concrete footpaths like a diving stuka. Now, what is a stuka? Let's come to the... Can you come to page number 20? Come to page 20. Oh, where is my... Yes. A Stuka was a German dive bomber used in Second World War, which had ended only a few years before. That is a few years before this story takes place. The stuka would dive down very low and very fast, making a shrieking noise. It would then drop its bombs and soar up again. I will quickly show you a picture of a stuka. Here you go. If you guys can see. If you have ever seen movies from that era, I can't see myself. This is what a Stuka airplane looks like.
They're yes, ma'am, now I can see.
Light, and they are very, you know, swift. So they could dive down low. And
ma'am, I think they have a fan forward.
Exactly. They have a propeller in the front. If you've seen movies from the Second World War, this such airplanes were very common from the German side. These were basically German airplanes, very fast, very noisy. They could very quickly come down, attack on the enemy, and then quickly glide back up. Okay. The boy, Clive, compares the noise of those wheels with the noise of a Stuka. Now, if you notice, where did the text go? He says, other children, most of them admittedly older than I. That is, children who were a little older than me, but some of them infuriatingly not. But there were others who would make me angry. Why? Because they were younger than me. Theek hai? They were children of all age groups, some who were my age, some who were older than me. And I was most annoyed, infuriatingly not, this needs explanation. Why? Because he says, I was most annoyed with the children who were younger than me, and they could make billy cards better and more advanced, more sophisticated compared to what I was doing. Okay? The best I could manage was a sawn-off fruit box. Sawn-off fruit box. Do you know what a saw is? Ari ka pata hai, alif madda ari?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, that's exactly what it means. So, from the word saw, the action of... Yoji, when I look up saw, this is what comes up.
Ma'am, can you...
I'll show you one. Here is what a saw looks like. Ari.
Yes.
Okay. And using a saw, the act of using a saw is called.
Ma'am, saw is used for to cut wood.
Exactly. So sawn is that I had used a saw to cut a fruit box, a fruit carton, and then used it to make mounted on a frame of fence paling. Fence palings are those wooden panels used to make a fence, because you know that unlike our houses, see, in Pakistan, we have houses made out of bricks, and we have a concrete wall outside our houses, isn't it so? But in America, in Australia, people use a fence around their house. Like this. Can you see the white fence around the house?
Yes, ma'am. So beautiful.
These houses in Australia, they are also made of wood, and the fences around are also made of wood. The reason being, number one, they have a lot of timber. Number two, houses made out of wood are very cozy. In Australia, the winters are extremely cold and the summers are extremely hot, just like unlike Pakistan. But their weather is somewhat like our area as well. But their winters are more severe since they are closer to the pole. So the houses, they are made out of wood, and the boundary wall is called a fence, which is also made of wood. And Clive's billy cart was made, the seat was made out of a sawn off portion of a fruit carton, nailed or hammered onto those fence palings.
Yes, ma'am.
With drearily silent rubber wheels taken off an old pram. Now, the wheels were from an old pram, a pushchair, a baby's pushchair, and they wouldn't make much noise. Do you think that's a good thing that the wheels didn't make noise? Do you think that's a good thing or a bad thing? His cart is not making noise.
Yes, ma'am, it's a good thing.
It's a good thing, good. After school and at weekends, boys came from all over the district to race on the Sunbeam Avenue paths. Now, where is the race taking place? It's taking place at the Sunbeam Avenue. And when does it take place? After school and at weekends. Every day after school and especially on the weekends. All over the, and from where are the boys coming? From all over the district. इर्द-गिर्द के इलाके से जितने बच्चे थे वो सारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट के बच्चे उधर जमा होते थे. There would be 20 or 30 carts, two-thirds of them with ball race wheels. Now, out of 20 to 30, two-thirds had those ball-bearing wheels which we just spoke about. The noise was indescribable. And obviously, those ball-bearing wheels, although faster and stronger, they were very noisy as a Stuka. There would be about half an hour's racing before the police came. We would race for half an hour until the police would come. Now, why would the police come? It would come because, look at the last sentence. Residents often took the law into their own hands, hosing the grim-faced riders as they went shrieking by. What do you think the word hosing mean? Somebody other than Ariba.
What was the sentence?
I'll underline it. Hosing the grim-faced riders as they went shrieking by. What do you think the word hosing means? What is a hose?
A water pipe.
Exactly, spraying them with water. Where are the pictures?
And the plants.
Oh, ho, khul jaye please. Nahi bhai, tasveerein kehti hain aaj to humne khulna hi nahi hai. This is a hose. A fancy hose.
Yes, ma'am. I have
a water pipe with a, you know, with a front used to water the plants. So hosing the grim-faced riders ka kya matlab hua?
Ma'am, yani ki, ma'am, water bhi na usse saaf karna, ma'am.
Bachchon ko saaf karte the wo pani se.
Nahi, mere matlab, ma'am, wo gaadiyon ko.
Unlocking.
Not, yes, throwing the residency, we are talking about the residents over here, theek hai, jo log, the people who lived on Sunbeam Avenue, okay, what would they do? They would take law into their own hands, theek hai, wo, they used to act themselves as the police, and what would they do? They would hose the grim-faced riders, grim-faced, you know, with a lot of attention, a lot of concentration, the riders were fully concentrating on their race. And what would the residents do? They would spray these children with their hose pipes, water from their hose pipes. And obviously, what happened? As they went shrieking by, as the children's go-karts went shrieking by. Why? Why were they shrieking? Why was the cart shrieking? Because it was noisy, like a Stuka. Okay, I'll read paragraph 2 and then we'll bring the lesson to an end. Okay, Sunbeam Avenue ran parallel to Margaret Street, but it started higher and lasted longer. Carts racing down the footpath on the far side had a straight run of about a quarter of a mile all the way to the park. Carts racing down the footpath on the near side could go only half as far. although very nearly as fast, before being faced with a right angle turn into Irene Street. You need to understand the map or the route of the race. Here, a pram-wheeled cart like mine could demonstrate its sole advantage. The traction of the rubber tires made it possible to negotiate the corner in some style. It developed a historic lean over of the body and slide of the back wheels, which got me round the corner unscathed, leaving black smoking trails of burnt rubber. Mastery of this trick saved me from being relegated to the ranks of the little kids, than which there was no first fate. I had come to depend on being thought of as a big kid. Now, what was the route? The route was that the Sunbeam Avenue was the main area where the race took place, but it was before the Sunbeam Avenue ran parallel to Margaret Street, and obviously later on it turned into Irene Street. And before it turned into Irene Street, there was a right angle. Right angle is like this, okay? At 90 degree angle, there was a 90 degree turn. Now, what happened was that obviously the carts, which had metal wheels with bearings inside, obviously they would not have resistance, okay? There's less friction. So they were, for them, it was difficult to take that 90 degree turn. The only advantage that the pram wheel gave Clive was that the rubber around the tires made it easy for Clive to take the turn, moving up a little, alleviating on one side and, leaving tire marks and then taking the turn. Okay, I'll try to get a little video for this idea. And I'll post it in your WhatsApp group so that you can understand what is going on in this portion of the text. Okay? What I will do is, for those of you who do not have a book, I'll be posting the text on Google Classroom. I'd like you to give the story a read, although we'll be reading it again tomorrow. But I'd like you to give it a read so that you know what is happening in the story. And there are a lot of technical terms. There's a lot of specialist vocabulary in this text. You should know what is going on. Underline the difficult words and find out their meanings as well. Okay. With that, we come to the end of our lesson. 4 minutes extra. Thank you very much for your time. And see you tomorrow, inshallah. Allah.
Allah.